Yeah, Om Amriteshwarye Namaha. This is a very tradition of Amrita that's why I wanted to open. We always start a talk with a Om Amriteshwarye Namaha, and in our college we never wish with a hello or good morning. We always wish with a Namah Shivaya. So I wanted to keep the tradition of Amrita. So that is my first slide. And this is the brief about the computer science department. It has started in the year 2002, and we have grown quite a lot in the 6 years. We have 2 bachelor's program, one in computer science and one in information technology. Now it's no longer a separate department in Amrita. And we have started our first postgraduate program also in embedded systems. And mostly by next year, we will have our second postgraduate program started. And our infrastructure is, we have classrooms with a seating capacity of 60-70. With OHP facility in all classrooms, and right now we have also started having a LCD in 2 to 3 classrooms. So very soon we will have a LCD projector in every classroom. If we require audio video teaching facility, then we have 3 seminar halls which we can book in advance. So this is one of our e-learning center. I have a bigger picture of this. This is what we would be using for the EduSat thing, for the program of IIT Bombay. So this is our video conferencing hall. We have 3 screens there, and we have always our 3 campuses seen simultaneously, the Bangalore, Coimbatore, and for the first year programming labs, we have 3 labs actually. One is a thin client lab with a Linux server, and 2 computer labs. Every lab has 34 computers, and other than that, we have departmental labs for the faculty and some senior students. Now this is the curriculum which almost all of you have been telling, so I'll just skip it off. We have the usual C concepts, arrays, the functions, pointers, structures, up to files. And the prescribed textbook is Shom series, and for reference we mostly use Herbert Shield and Dennis Ritchie. Now this is one of our important features. Actually, I don't know, many of you mentioned that you have 8 faculty or 8 sections of C programming being taught in the same college. So how do you coordinate that all of you are in sync, like all the 8 faculty do a similar job? I don't know whether you have addressed this problem, or in Amrita we have 3 campuses and we have 8 sections running in all the 3 campuses. So we have a method of coordinating that all the 24 faculty synchronize well, and that is taken care by defining this a well-defined course plan in the beginning in addition to your course. So this is how we make use of the flexibility, since ours is also an autonomous system. So although we have a prescribed curriculum, but faculty have the flexibility of modifying it to their taste. But what is done in such courses, the first year courses, we have a chief mentor and local mentors in every campus. So we don't do the modifications as we require, but we discuss and we make a course plan. So in the beginning of the semester, we have all section wise, topic wise, and also the question paper pattern decided in the beginning itself. So all the 3 campuses will know how to go about the course, and periodically we have the test also at the same time on the same dates in all the 3 campuses. So even that is very well synchronized. So we are one rare university which is autonomous, but we run across campuses and still we are able to maintain that synchronization. So that is one of our good features. And yeah, this I brought it on a slide intentionally because I wanted to focus. I saw many of you showing your lab programs, but in Bangalore rather I had made a focus that most of you list out the programs just like that. So in every lab, we had made that on what concept you are going to give the program, and as few faculty were addressing that there is a diverse set of students, and some students finish the lab very fast and some of them are lagging behind because they come from different backgrounds. So what we had done is this basic set of programs, the first set is compulsory for all. Yeah, that part, the first beginning programs are compulsory for all. And the additional programs can be done by the good students who finish the lab soon. So we don't give very big programs. We see that, see, actually the students in our local colleges are not so sharp as the IIT students. So at the end of the course, the focus is that at least few lines of code they should write independently, because students end up memorizing the programs and writing it. They don't write even 10 lines of code without any help. So that is why we have made the first set of programs very simple. So the whole lab is divided into 10 labs, and in each we have a concept to be discussed that day and very simple programs to be done by all, and some heavier level programs. We don't take that programs of leap year and all on the very first day, because the concept of finding a leap year is itself is something complicated, and they are neither comfortable with the syntax nor with the logic. So the focus is that either we make the logic simpler so that they focus on the syntax, or we make it a problem solving class where we don't focus on the syntax. So we should keep the two things decoupled. So this is actually just the 10 labs which we have. So here also, see, even in case of a for loop, it is here it is very specifically mentioned that all the looping constructs should be used, and the programs are designed in a manner that the focus is that for that program you have to use a do while, and the program question is such that it cannot be done without a do while. So the students understand when you have three looping constructs, when you should use a for, when you should use a while, and when you should use a do while. So every small program has a concept in that. It is not just designed at random. Okay, this I can just skip. This was actually, some slides are made for a different purpose. As I said, we have a course plan. We have a very well-designed academic calendar also in the beginning, in which all our dates are well-defined. And we do a course registration just like the IITs. And we go through various methods of teaching. I'll skip this slide because it is, the evaluation consists of the attendance first, that is 80%. So if you don't satisfy that requirement, you cannot take the exam. And the continuous assessment, we have a 50% for theory courses, that is the continuous assessment part, in which we have two periodical tests of 15 marks each, and 20 marks is again the flexibility of the faculty. But here for the first year courses, we still have a well-defined pattern. Like for the higher semesters, we give it as a flexibility, but in the first years, we have at least three quizzes have to be conducted, and 1 5 marks can be for a project or whatever, and the end semester exams carries a 50% weightage. For the lab courses, every week lab sessions are evaluated, and that is taken for 50 marks. So almost every alternate week a viva has to be conducted, and that has to be, the marks have to be recorded for every week. And there is a mid semester exam for 20 marks and a end semester lab exam for 30 marks. This is our grading system. Just like IITs, we also have a relative grading system where we decide on the, our minimum passing marks can sometimes be 30 also depending on the course. So it's not necessary that 50 is the cutoff for passing like that. It depends on what is the level of the course, and the highest A can be from anything about 70, 80 depending on the course. So we have so many grades from starting from A plus to D, and D is the, below D is fail. Yeah, now here I had brought in a few sample questions. I have the soft copies which I will pass on, but why I have put this on the slide is what I was seeing is we generally set up question papers or we conduct a quiz in a very random manner. But here we have tried, I have a few set of questions which is only on the concept of switch case. So how you can bring about a small concept with so many questions so that nothing is missed. Now just 5 minutes all of you, I don't have the answers in few. But just browse through each and you will find that whatever concept you tell in a small switch case, everything is there in these questions. So if you design your multiple choice like this, students at the end when they solve such a quiz, on that concept they are very strong. So just please browse through it and look for the answers yourself. And you will find that everything about a switch case is there in these 6-7 questions. So the concept is retained if you put it like this. And as I said, one of our major strengths is our own learning management system, the AUMS, where starting from the course registration, maintenance of attendance, uploading of the course material, quiz conduction, marks entry, up to the mark sheet printing, everything is taken care by this. And so we faculty, actually we never use Moodle or anything. From the beginning we have been using our own university management system. That's all I have to say.
Hello, what's the seating capacity of your seminar hall where the EDUSAT is?
120 almost, 120 it can
accommodate. 120. And lab, Like
lab, we have 34 in each lab. So, but all labs are adjacent, so we can conduct it parallelly, like in 2-3 labs, no?
Okay.
We can